When we talk about food systems, first and foremost, it has to be sustainable. But sustainable food systems have three primary characteristics. It has to be economically sustainable, it has to be environmentally sustainable, as well as socially sustainable. Economic sustainability is not just in terms of increasing GDP, gross domestic product. It has to be such that it provides economic well-being for all populations of our world. And this is where we must see that our food systems provide access and availability of food to the poorest populations. Of course, environmental sustainability has to be such that our food systems do not disturb our environment, do not contribute to the impact of climate change, do not deplete our water resources. And this, of course, will mean our change in our mindset on how we see food loss and food waste. And of course, social sustainability, it has to be totally inclusive. It's not only in terms of increasing economic wealth, but also that this economic wealth spreads across to bringing about social amenities to all the population so that you have an inclusiveness in development. At IFAD, this is how we see sustainable food systems. Three primary pillars. When every one of these is not available, then the system is not able to stand. And first of all, I have to commend the United Nations and the international community for agreeing on the 17 goals that are the backbone of Agenda 2030, which in essence aims to leave no one behind. And if we are to achieve the SDGs or Agenda 2030 in perhaps about 14 years from now, we'll have to look at where poverty and hunger run deepest in the world. It is in developing countries, in rural areas of developing countries. And their source of livelihoods and for their lives is agriculture, small-scale agriculture, smallholder producers. And I believe that if we are to achieve Agenda 2030 and leave no one behind, we have to be sure that the 2 billion people who depend on smallholder agriculture, whether it's crops, tree crops, fisheries, or livestock, are included in the agenda. Currently, they are primarily invisible and forgotten. We have about 1 million children today that are stunted due to malnutrition. Almost 800 million go to bed hungry every night. Agenda 2030 addresses their problems. There is no way we can achieve Agenda 2030 if the rural area is not transformed such that people have access to food at affordable prices, and that their business, which is agriculture, smallholder agriculture, is made to thrive. This will involve massive policy decisions, a change in mindset to see agriculture as a business. This is the primary step. We have to change the way we see agriculture as an economic activity that not only feeds people, it generates wealth, it creates employment. And because women and girls are a primary centerpiece in agriculture, in smallholder agriculture, we must focus on women. They have to have rights to land, they have to have a voice, they have to have access to financial services, they have to be able to organize themselves. So for us at IFAD, our problem, our point of view is very clear. The solution rests in massive transformation of rural areas into vibrant economies.